Hello everyone, this is Aida Gholami from Agrimed Soft Research Lab, and in today's video I'm going to teach you how to calculate correlation in SPSS. You can see I have my data listed in here, and in previous videos I've told you how to input your data, how to enter your data to SPSS, and you know that we have the variable names in the first row, in they are the title of the variables, and then in variable view also we have another sheet named variable view, which all our variables are listed and we have some details about them. Then in data view we have data in each column for each variable. So you know I have the gender, weight, height example because I've seen that example a lot in internet, and then I decided maybe this is the example that most users can relate to it and can understand it, so I've used that also. Now let's get started. So in order to calculate correlation in SPSS, you need to go to Analyze tab, and then in Correlate option you see bivariate, so we are going through this one. I click on that and you can see I have previously I've selected weight and height, but in order to select them at first you see something like this. At first you see that all your variables are listed in left side, and then your variables to be analyzed are listed in the right side. So at first you cannot see any variables in the right box, and then you can import them. Okay, so I select weight and then I press the import button, so it's imported. Then I select height and select import, and I have weight and height right now in here. Then you can see correlation coefficients Pearson, Kendall, and Spearman. So I want to have Pearson. And then test of significance, two-tailed or one-tailed. I want two-tailed also. And it's checked flex significant correlation, so that whenever you have a significant correlation, it lets you know with asterisks. So I click OK, and before I click OK, I want to give you some explanations about the whole correlation thing. So let's get into Paint. In correlation coefficient, in Pearson correlation coefficient specifically, which we want to run in here, you have the coefficients vary from -1 to +1, and then here you have also zero. Zero means basically no relationship at all, so it means that they are not correlated in any level. So then you have -1 means that these two variables are correlated in the most negative way, so they have a strongest relationship in the reverse side. So when one variable goes up, the other one goes down. When one of them increases, the other one decreases. Then you have +1. So +1 correlation means that these two variables are correlated in the most positive way. So it means that they are directly and strongly correlated. It means that when one variable goes up, the other one also goes up. When one of them increases, the other one also increases. When one of them decreases, the other one also decreases. So that's how you can interpret the correlation coefficient. And then in here you saw that you have some significance test, so it's two-tailed right now. What does it mean? It means that you have a null hypothesis which says that the two variables are not related to each other, are not correlated to each other, and the correlation is zero. So we have the null hypothesis that says Pearson correlation is zero, so that they do not have any relationship. Then you have another one, which is alternative hypothesis, which is H1 or HA, they're not different, which says that the correlation coefficient is not zero. It's anything but zero, so that they have relationship in some way. They are related to each other in some ways, okay? And then when we say the test is two-tailed, it's this one. I'm gonna go for one-tailed. Then we have something like this. The H1 is P more than 0 or less than 0. Then you should see what is your hypothesis and go for it. In here, P is anything but 0. So let's get into SPSS. So I want the two-tailed Pearson flex significant correlations. I click OK. So you can see the output result is in now shown in here. I have weight and height, weight, width, weight. We know that each variable with itself has one correlation. So that's the strongest relationship. It's obvious, and also height to height has one. Then weight to height and height to weight, there's no difference. You can see it's minus 0.13. So what it means? It means that they have reverse correlation. So whenever the height goes up, the weight goes down. There's no need to mention that these data are not logical. They're created using rand between function in Excel, so these results do not mean anything. So you can see the correlation is negative. It means that they are correlated in the reverse direction. And then you can see the significance for two-tailed is 0.48. And then we now want to compare it to alpha, which is 5% in here. So I compare p-value, which is 0.48, to alpha level, which is 5%. You can see that this is so much bigger than the alpha level. So what it means that the results are not significant and they do not have significant meaning. That was for the two variables correlation, and now I want to get the three of them correlation. So I have the gender in here. You know that gender is a nominal variable, but we have zero for male and one for female. So we have coded them so that SPSS can understand. I go to analyze again, and I go to correlate by variate, and I import that also. Pearson two-tailed, okay. So you have another output table, which you can see weight to weight, weight to height, weight to male or female. So let's get into it step by step. Weight with weight has one correlation, it's obvious. Then weight to height, it's minus 0.13. What it means? It means that whenever height goes up, weight goes down. Then you have weight to gender, being male or female. It's also negative and it's minus 0.16. What it means, if you remember, I said we have mail 0 and female as 1. Okay, when we say whenever the weight goes up, the gender goes down, it means that when weight goes up, the gender is male. So males have more weight than female. Male is smaller. Male's value that we have defined for SPSS is smaller than female's value. So whenever weight goes up, this number should go down. So whenever weight goes up, the male's number goes down. So it gets into 0. So then we have also the significance values. We have 0.48, which we said is not meaningful. And in here we have also 0.39. It's smaller than it. It's not smaller than 5% or 1%, which was the alpha level. So they are not meaningful still. And then we have the other tables for height to weight. You can see the same numbers, okay? Height to weight, height to height. I'm sorry, height to weight minus 13. You can see the same number. Height to height, 1. Height to male or female is 0.17. So that's the new number. You can see that in here, the height and gender have direct positive relationship. What it means? It means that whenever height goes up, the gender value also goes up. The gender value was for female was 1. Whenever height goes up, gender goes up. So females have more height than male. I said this data set is, you know, is not real, so the results are not meaningful also. Then we have gender relationship to weight. That's the repetitive number. We had it also in here. And then we have also another repetitive number. It was in here. And then gender to gender, which is 1. And also significance levels are also repetitive. So that's it. So that's it for today's video. I hope you learned something new. Please don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. I'll see you in the next videos and bye.